Srikant Adult Chemistry. So in this video, we're discussing about miscellaneous reactions or incomplete reactions, part 4. Okay. So this is the first incomplete reaction. So these compound heating with an acid. So we need to find the product. So first we just take the given compound. So this is the given compound. Here this compound is react with H plus ion. In that time, any one of the OH group can be passing away with the H plus ion in the form of water. I just take the OH group from this carbon. So we get this product. Okay, after that it is a after here 1, 2 bond shifting can be possible. I mean, so this bond can be shifting towards to this carbon. In that time we get the product like, so this is, we can say also ring expansion, and these positive charge can be shifting towards to this carbon. So we get the product this. So after removing of H plus ion, so this H plus ion can be removed. So what we have, the sigma electrons from this oxygen and hydrogen, in between of oxygen and hydrogen, those are shifting towards the lone pair electrons towards oxygen atom. Then we get the product like, so this is the, okay students, this is next reaction, next incomplete reaction. So this reaction react with KSH. So in that time, one of the bromine atom can be replaced from the compound with the thio alcohol group. So here KSH can be present in the form of K plus plus SH minus. So this is, we call as thio alcohol group. So it is replaced with the any one of the two bromine atoms. So actually here we have two possibilities, but these bromine can be stable. Why? Because the lone pair electrons here at the bromine, we have three lone pair electrons. So one of the lone pair electron can be participate in the resonance with the benzene ring. So it is more stable to remove from the to separate from the benzene ring. So the SH group can replace the these bromine, first bromine. Okay, so then we get the product like, plus KBr. So this is the final product. Okay students, this is next incomplete or miscellaneous reaction. So this reaction can be started with a given compound is a carboxylic acid. So first we just take the given compound. So this is given compound. This compound first react with a thionyl chloride. In that time, this OH group can be replaced with chlorine. So then we got the product SiO chloride. Okay. So here we just lost the hydrogen chloride and sulfur dioxide. Okay. After this substance react with the ammonia. So in that time, from the ammonia, one hydrogen and this chlorine can passing away in the form of hydrogen chloride. So then we get the product amide. Okay. After this amide react with the bromine in presence of potassium hydroxide solution, we call as this is Hoffman bromide reaction. So in the Hoffman bromide degradation reaction, the amide group can be converted to the amine. So this CO group can be disappear. So we get the product like, so this is the final product. Okay students, this is next miscellaneous or incomplete reaction. So this reaction can be done in two steps. First, in the first step, it can undergoes bromination in presence of iron metal. After, it is undergoes acid hydrolysis. So see carefully. So this is the compound. So when this compound first react with the bromine in iron metal, so in this time, so here it may we got the bromination at this position. So for NH group, it is maybe NH group can be located at para position, and keto or ester group can be located at meta position. For this compound, it is for NH group it is para position, for a COO it is meta position. So we get the bromine at this position. So we get the product like this. Okay, after this product undergoes acid hydrolysis, in that time, so the bonds broken here. Here for this side we need to add the OH group, here need to add the hydrogen, here also OH group, here hydrogen. So after we get the compound, I mean product, like so this is the one of the product, and we get the another product also, that is here after adding of hydrogen we get the amine group, here after addition of hydrogen we get the alcohol group. So these are the final products in this two in this reaction. Okay students, this is the next incomplete or miscellaneous reaction. So these type of reactions we get previous videos several times. So but it is more important model, that's why I just repeating every time. So I just want to say each and every example for this. So first the hydrogen iodide can be present as H plus and I minus. So after we need to take the given compound. So for this ether we have the two lone pairs on the oxygen. So the reaction is started by the proton. So one of the lone pair can be shared to the H plus ion, then we get the product like this. After it is react with iodide ion in that time. So if you see this, if you close this, it is phenol. The phenol. So the phenol, the phenyl group is stabilized by the resonance. So it can it can donate the electrons very lessly. So at the same time, when iodine here iodine can be attacking on the methyl group. In that time, these sigma electrons are shifting toward the oxygen as lone pair electrons. We get the phenol. Why? Because phenol can form the phenoxide ion, so it is more stable. That's why. So with phenol, it can form the it can form the phenol, and we get the methyl iodide as a second product. Okay, students, this is the next incomplete reaction. So here for this compound, we got the acid hydrolysis. This type model also we get more times, but it is also very important. I just that's why I am repeat every time. So just take the initial compound. Here the reaction is initiated by the H plus ion. So these pi electrons are shifting toward the carbon, and this carbon made the bond with hydrogen, and for this carbon we get the positive charge. So then we get here a secondary carbocation, but here we have one possibility to get the tertiary carbocation. So here the methyl group can be shifting towards to here. So here we just do the shifting of methyl group. So then after rearrangement of methyl group, we get the substance like so this is the substance. Now we get the tertiary carbocation. So these tertiary carbocation react with the water. So in that time in the water we have H plus and OH plus ion. The OH plus ion can be attached to here, and we just lost the proton. So at the starting we just initiate the reaction with the proton. So at last the proton can be comes out. So then we get the product. So this is the final product. That's all. Students, this is next incomplete reaction. So when I observe this reaction, this incomplete reaction is look like it is a allyl condensation. Here we need to take the 2 moles of given substance. This is a cyclopentanone. So we need to take the two moles of pentanone, cyclopentanone. So one is taken like this, and another one taken like this. So when these two are react with the influence of dilute potassium hydroxide solution. So here in that time at this carbon we have, this is the alpha carbon for this compound. So at this carbon we have the two alpha hydrogen atoms. In that time one of the alpha hydrogen atom can be shifting towards to can be attached to these oxygen, and these alpha carbon attached to for this double bond. So resulting we get the product like this. After it is a strong heating, I mean condensation, we lost the water molecule from the from these two carbon atoms. From this carbon we lost the hydrogen atom. For this carbon we lost the hydroxyl OH. So resulting we lost the water molecule, and a pi bond can be developed here. Okay students, this is next incomplete reaction or miscellaneous reaction. So in this reaction the given compound react with can do the in two steps. In the first step it is react with methyl iodide in potassium sulfate solution. After it is undergoes nitration. This is nitration mixer. So we will see. So this is given compound. When it is react with the methyl iodide in K2SO4 solution, in that time these hydrogen can be replaced by the iodine, replaced by the methyl group. I mean we lost the hydrogen iodide, and the methyl group can be replaced the position of hydrogen. So then we get the product. So this is we get the product. After it is undergoes nitration with a nitration mixer. So in that time, so we get the product like, so nitration can be possible at ortho position and para position. In the para position we don't have enough place. So for this ring it can undergoes ortho position, and for these two rings, any one of the ring, it undergoes the para position. So then we get the product. So this is the final product. That's all. Okay students, this is next incomplete reaction. So for this reaction is initiated by the compound with sodium azide. After it is undergoes reduction, so we will see what will happen here one by one. So first I need to take the given compound. So this compound react with sodium azide, okay, in presence of DMO. So in that time the sodium atom and bromine can be passing away in the form of sodium bromide. So here we just lost the sodium bromide, and we get the product like, after it is undergoes reduction in presence of palladium on carbon. So in that time we just lost the nitrogen atom, and we get the final product like. So this is the final product. So from N3 we just lost the two nitrogens. In place of two nitrogens we replace with the two hydrogen atoms. this is the final reaction.